Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the words of the Mesillas Yesharim, and the Ramchal continues to explain to us the ideas of anava, of what it means to be truly a humble person. And he writes, "V'tamidei Rabbi Gamliel yachichoich." The students of Rabbi Gamliel, they will demonstrate this concept that we are discussing of why it is that a person should not look for any positions of honor and glory, because those will take him away from his humility. They were extremely poor, and they needed to take positions of some kind of a power to make money to rescue them from their abject poverty. However, nevertheless, they refused to take a job where there was going to be any authority, because they did not want to have a position that was going to take them away from the midah of anivus, of humility. Like our sages teach us, so Rabbi Gamliel said to his students, he says, "Do you think that I'm offering you positions of sorah, of leadership and authority, and that you are going to rule over other people? On the other hand, the fact that I'm putting you in a position where you're going to be a leader, I'm giving you a position of avdus, of servitude over here. Because it's not easy to take care of Klal Yisrael. It's not easy to tend to the flock of the Jewish people. There's a lot of achrayus, a lot of responsibility, and therefore, even though you might think that you are elevating yourself to a position of power, the reality is that you are actually becoming more in servitude to the people." V'amru oid, further it says, "Woe is to the people who take on the positions of rabbanus, of leadership, because why? It buries those who hold on to that position." How do we know that that's true? We learn it from Yosef HaTzadik, the son of Yaakov Avinu, since that he took upon himself a position of authority. As we know, he went down to Mitzrayim, to Egypt, and he became second in command next to the Paro. Meis Kaidim Echav. The Torah tells us that he died before his brothers. He was the youngest next to Binyamin of all of his brothers, and yet he was the first one to die. Why did he die? Because when a person is holding on to a position of authority and they're utilizing that kayach to rule over others, so therefore it causes them to die before the rest. Klal Shodafa. The main idea is, you should know that when you are in a position of authority, it's nothing more than a tremendous burden on the shoulders of those that carry it. If you're carrying the tzibur, you're carrying the community, you're carrying a kehila, you're carrying even a family, you're carrying whatever position you are in that's higher than others, it's a big burden on you. Because as long as a person is just dwelling amongst the rest of Klal Yisrael, Muvla Bein HaNashim, he's kind of like swallowed up amongst everybody else, which means he's not particularly distinguished from any of the other Jewish people. Eino Nitpas Ela Al Atzmai. So therefore, he's only going to be held accountable for himself. If he does something wrong, he has to answer to Hashem for his sins. If he makes a mistake, he has to answer to HaKadosh Baruch Hu for his mistakes. However, Kevan Shinis Ali L'Rabbanus Yisrael, once that he gets appointed and elevated to a position of leadership and authority, then Kfar Hu Nitpas Al Mashu Mi Al Kol Mi Shetachas Yodo Memshaltei. He now is held accountable for everyone that is under his jurisdiction. Anyone that he's responsible for, he's responsible for their deeds and their actions and their misdeeds as well. Because he's responsible to watch over each and every one of them. And he has to guide them. He has to tend to them with the proper day of knowledge, vahaskil, and understanding. He's responsible to straighten out and correct their actions and their deeds. And if he doesn't do that, then their sins that they have committed are going to be on his head. Ksiv omru chachamim. That's what our sages teach us in this particular case over here. And that is that if a person ends up being in omru chachamim, that's what our sages teach us, that if a person is in such a position of power like that, then they are going to have the responsibility to watch over everybody else, and it's up to the leader, it's up to that person who's in that position to make sure that people are going in the right direction. And if not, then it will be on your head. That case, says Rabbi Gamliel to his students, don't think because you take on a position of power, you should become haughty. On the other hand, once you realize how much responsibility is, that itself will be the most humbling aspect of your life. Have a wonderful day and a wonderful Shabbos.